So we've got some internal rust here inside these tubes.
Okay, pretty finished with the chassis. I'm not happy with the shock absorber. I'm going to get a softer one for that. Thanks, little dog. The wheel bearings on the wheel, I'm also going to have to change. But apart from that, it's all ready to go. So, in comes the pod. Can hardly fit the bloody thing in. I've had to move the bike out to make some space, and here is the pod. Again with the Russian steel, it's pretty solid. It's probably over-engineered. Well, it's not over-engineered, it's just over-made. You know, the steel's thicker than it needs to be and that sort of thing. The floor ain't good here. It ain't good there. It's gonna have to be cut out. And replaced a bit there. Everything else is pretty good. I think it was probably well treated. Nice big boot in there. Might think about putting a little door in the back here for that access, because the seat, you have to pull the seat out to actually get into it. All of this trim is all pretty knocked about, but you know, you can see it's pretty bad, but it's solid. It's still solid, you know. It's not like tinny trim. It's like solid trim that can be fixed up and made lovely again. I haven't decided about chromium yet, so we'll go ahead with some of this. There's the seat and everything, so away we go. And bam, there it is. It's a beautiful thing. Look at that. Beautiful thing. Made from that steel. Made some slice along here. Bent it over, welded in. Same. So we got absolutely spot on accuracy. You can see the shape. And everything is perfect. So that will go on there. We'll get some 10mm holes drilled and paint it black. Beautiful. All right, got this thing in. This still flops down, that's good. This is coming down too far, as I said, we're gonna find the right position here and lop that off and tidy that up, but that is really strong. That's not going anywhere. That fits over that beautifully. Just got to work out how to get this, the guard that goes over here, back on, because that's another essential thing for the engineer, the structural engineer that has to give a compliance certificate to the, it's actually to the sidecar, not the bike. The bike gets registered and then be much easier on this side. And then away we go. Grabs hold of the ball, we shall call it, for want of a better name. Apparently it does actually have a name. All of these things have names, remarkably. Alright, I can feel that tightening up now. That is on, and that is a complete success. It's loose because I haven't tightened it up, haven't got washers or anything there. We'll grease it all up before we pop it on. But I'm going to be able to tighten that up, and that is rocking the bike. That is marvellous. Absolutely marvellous. So, we got this sidecar. It was about a grand, it was 1100. I have no garage space. I have no money anymore. I spent my tax return on that. Now, it's things like this. This piece, this is a beast of a piece to get hold of. There we go. But I want to show you how I made it. And there it is. There it is. Already made for us. There you go. A little bit of flattening off there. And there it is, go. Tap down in there. We have this beautiful bit. We've got thread in there. That's a 12 mil 1.5 angle, which I think is how much base takes up in a single, whatever that is. All right, now we put that in the, you saw in the lathe to drill that out properly. Chris did a marvelous job on that. We could do it in the drill press at home or whatever if we needed to, but to have the lathe was just magnificent. And that's pretty good. And we're just gonna grind that to a circular finish. And then it will be ready to bolt upon the bike. All right, now we had this bar. Going to cut out this section here, but decided to put in this bar here, tacked it in, drilled holes from the underside, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 I think, welded the bar on from the other side through the holes, and then cleaned it up. Now, this device here, I finally worked it out. This knob was rusted solid. So it never occurred to me that it is, in fact, a button. So you push that, whole thing slides forward, and there you've got a little door to get out. No problem. Click, solid, locks back in place. So that is genius. That was a bit of a bicycle cable tube running down in the center there that's getting pushed forward by that. And it was just needed pulling apart all this down here, this stuff here, just literally pulled apart, cleaned up, and it just works beautifully now, just like a bolt one. Soviet. All right, I've done a test on this. You can see this little bit of red here. That looks pretty red. That's just a test, and it wasn't the paint. It was a red Sharpie. Presidents have changed the weather with these things. There we are, it's quite a bit redder. That's just the Sharpie. Did quite well. You can see the color change in that little bit of the screw there that I couldn't get behind it. So it's quite dramatic color change, which is pretty good, which is what we wanted.
So here we are for a final briefing. There's that ball joint connection with the little strapping thing that we made. You can see all the connections there. Solid as, and the little handbrake. Now I had to make a couple of little pieces, this piece and a little piece in there, to make all that move or stop moving. And all right, so we put a bit of paint on the front just to cover up all the red. It's sort of similar white, and managed to find the same pinstripes, sort of pretty close. So that looks all right. Just painted that bar blue, give it a bit of thing, bit of spark. The rain we had destroyed my neighbor's living room, so they had to throw out their Persian rug. So thanks very much for that. That looks pretty good. And we got these little markers. These are markers off trucks, off the side of trucks. They run on 24 volt and 12 volt, so they're not as bright as they should be. Got that little front marker there. So we're gonna get a little shade for that, little cage around it. Same around the front here, little cage for it. Stop the rock splash. It's not fantastic, but it's certainly near enough for a sheep station, I'll tell you what.